Hello everyone, my name is Phil and I'm an engineer at OpenAI. Today, I'd like to tell you about Triton, a language and compiler for GPU programming that we've been working on for some time. This talk will be divided into three parts. First of all, we'll talk a little bit about Triton, what it is and how it works. Then we'll go over some examples of how to use it in practice. And finally, we'll talk about some performance numbers. So what is Triton exactly? Well, Triton is a new language and compiler for GPU programming that we've been developing at OpenAI. The goal of Triton is really to enable machine learning experts and engineers that have no CUDA programming experience at all to write their own GPU code in a way that's productive and fast. And the goal, in fact, is that they should be able to write code that's on par with what an expert would be able to write. But you might wonder, why would we even need a new language at all, since there are already quite a few tools for programming GPUs? Well, I would argue that the tools that exist so far are not perfect. First of all, CUDA is a little bit too low level, in the sense that it's quite challenging to write. So researchers often have to talk to GPU experts and provide them with some specs that they can implement and give back their code. And then whenever there's a slight modification to do, communication has to happen again. And this can really slow down the pace of iterative research in AI organizations. Another issue with CUDA is that it's really hard to communicate sometimes for GPU programmer and machine learning experts. For example, some GPU programmers might have some constraints on how they need to design their kernels, such as some data might need to be pre-computed, for example. And it's not always clear to the outside eye what this should be the case. So communication can be really difficult when you use CUDA. And it's true that there are some other languages and compilers available that are higher level. For example, TVM or some dialects of MLIR. But these are not perfect either. One of their problems is that users cannot really use them to define their own data structures. So if you have some sparse tensor you want to use, or even some triangular matrix, then you're generally out of luck when you use these frameworks. And another issue that they have is that they don't really give you control over how to schedule work across the GPU. So you have some parallelization strategy in mind in terms of what SM should do what, or how the L2 cache should be partitioned, then it's usually not something that you can implement easily using these frameworks. So how is Triton different exactly? Well, Triton is a little bit between these two levels of abstractions. So you still define tensors, like in TVM or like in high-level DSLs, but instead of being in the DRAM of your GPU, they actually reside in the SRAM, like in CUDA, for example. And then you can modify these tensors using torch-like operators. So with this programming model, you really get the best of both worlds. Machine learning experts can be very productive and use a torch-like environment to program their GPUs. And there are three main features that go with Triton. First of all, it's embedded in Python. So kernels are written completely in Python using the syntax of the language. And then they can be JIT compiled for GPU using the decorator, the Triton.JIT decorator. Very much like the torch script JIT would work. Another core tenet of the Triton methodology is that users retain low-level control of their memory accesses. So you still have pointers in Triton. You can declare tensors of pointers in SRAM, and then you can dereference them to get tensors of value in SRAM. And then you can use them however you like. And the final crucial point for the Triton language is to have an efficient compiler, because having a very flexible, high-level language really does you no good if the compiler cannot compile this into very efficient binary code. So to go over a quick history of the project, it started in 2018 during my PhD. I worked really hard on it, and about a year and a half later, it was published at the Maple workshop at the PLDI conference, alongside with an open source prototype. I kept working on it, and in 2020, about a year later, there was a collaboration with DeepSpeed in which block sparse attention was implemented in Triton, and this allowed wider usage of the Triton language. After that, I joined OpenAI and I kept working on it until a few months ago when we released the version 1.0 along with a blog post describing the language. So now I'd like to go over some examples of Triton, of how Triton works in practice. So the first thing we'll go over is a simple vector addition. So assume that you have a simple element-wise kernel that runs on a single streaming multiprocessor of your GPU and without bounds checking. So you would start your kernel by importing all the namespaces. So there are two main namespaces in Triton. You have the Triton frontend, which contains the JIT compiler and the autotuner. And then you have the Triton language, which I usually abbreviate as TL. And anything that you use in your kernel, all the SRAM level tensor functions, reside in the TL namespace. And so we'd start by declaring our kernel function, which in this case takes three inputs, the two inputs x and y and the output tensor z, as well as the size of the vector n. Then we would start by constructing the pointers in SRAM that we want to load from. And this can be done using a simple arrange function that we add to the base pointers of our tensors. And this gives you a tensor of about 1k pointers. Then we can use the tl.load function to dereference these pointers and get tensors of values still residing in SRAM. Then we can do our computations with them, which in this case is just a simple vector addition. And then finally, once we're done, we can just write back the result using the pointers to our output. So now our kernel is declared, and if we want to use it, we can just declare three torch tensors and simply pass them to our kernel function as arguments. And note that when I pass torch tensors to a Triton kernel, then the tensors are implicitly converted to pointers to their first element. Now, just a simple vector addition like this doesn't get you very far, because you really need it to work on vectors of any size and to work with bounds checking. So what you can do to solve this issue is just slightly modify the pointer arithmetic that I talked about. So now you have your pointer offsets, and you can also add them a term which corresponds to the offset of the particular program instance that's running. And then when you load your tensors using the tensors of pointers, then you can simply pass a tensor of Boolean that just corresponds to where the tensor should actually be loaded from memory. And then the only difference that you have to make in terms of how you run the kernel is now the number of kernel instances that I execute, the grid, is actually not a single element, but is actually consists of the sealed division of the size of your vector by the block size that you're using, in this case 1k. Another very useful example that we can go over is a few softmax, and we will see that we can actually write this few softmax kernel in less than 10 lines of Triton code. So it starts just as before, we import our namespaces, and now the functions just have four arguments, the pointer to the output tensor, a pointer to the input tensor, the stride between different rows of our matrix, and the n, the number of columns of our matrix. So here, our strategy is that each particular program instance that we're running is going to normalize a different row of our input matrix. We just still need to declare the tensors of pointers just like before, and this is something that we can do as follows. So we can just declare the range of rows handled by this program instance, which in this case is just given by the program ID, as well as the number of columns. And then we can just use standard pointer arithmetic to offset the row that we're processing and add all the columns indices that we're using. And then we can just use tl.load as before. And then once our data is in, once the row of the input matrix is in SRAM, we can just do our softmax on it by first casting it to float 32 and then removing the maximum and so on. And then once our softmax computation is done, we can just write back the normalized row to DRAM. So one thing you might wonder is, okay, Triton is good and it's relatively easy to program, but how well does it perform? So the simple vector addition that I talked about is a very low bar, but you can see that it actually works just as well as Torch. And this is because memory accesses in Triton, due to the optimizing compiler, are vectorized and coalesced. So performance is unsurprisingly on par with what Torch provides for vector element-wise. Now for softmax, it's quite more challenging of an application. And you can see that here, the PyTorch JIT actually doesn't work really well. It transfers about four times more data than necessary, which makes it about four times than it should. The native PyTorch implementation is slightly better, but on an A100 GPU that has about 1500 gigabytes of advertised bandwidth, you can see that it only reaches about 75% of it. The Triton implementation, on the other hand, it fits in only 10 lines of Triton code and achieves close to the peak performance of our GPU. You can also do a kernel similar to Softmax that computes the layer norm of a given matrix. And just as before, PyTorch kernels are not completely fused, and so they transfer more data than necessary. And even the Apex library, which is widely used for layer norm, actually quickly drops in performance. But with Triton, we can write a kernel that's much faster than both Apex and PyTorch. Another much more challenging and crucial application is matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication is a pillar of deep learning and often needs to be slightly modified. So having open source implementations of it is extremely valuable. You can see that Kublas, as expected, achieves close to peak performance on our A100 GPU. But as soon as you try to fuse a leaky ReLU, for example, you can see that it comes at about a 10% performance cost. With Triton, our based implementation can reach about the same performance as Kublas. And keep in mind, I haven't shown it in these slides, but it actually fits in about 25 lines of Triton code. And the good thing with Triton is when you try to fuse leaky ReLU, then it all happens in SRAM. So you don't need to transfer the activations back and forth, and you don't lose any performance at all. So that's it. Triton is an open source project with strong community support. The documentation is available at triton-lang.org, and the GitHub page is shown here. Thank you.